Welcome to the Explainer. All right, today we are diving into two fundamental economic ideas. And I promise, once you get them, you'll see productivity in a whole new light. It really changes how you think about who should be doing what on any team. So let's kick things off with a question that, you know, seems simple on the surface, but it's actually huge. I mean, think about it. Team projects at work, running a company, heck, even just figuring out who does the dishes. It all comes down to this core challenge. How do you get the most done?
Well, the answer, it turns out, really boils down to two key ideas. We've got absolute advantage and comparative advantage. Now, they sound kind of similar, but trust me, they are worlds apart. And knowing that difference, oh, it's everything.
So on one hand, you've got this idea of just being the best at something, you know, the most productive. That's the one that just makes sense to us, right? But the other one, it's a little trickier. It's not really about who's best. It's about who has the lowest cost. Who gives up the least to get the job done? And spoiler alert, that second one is the real game changer.
All right, so let's dig into that first one, absolute advantage. This is the concept we all kind of default to in our heads when we're comparing who's good at what.
So what is it? It's actually super straightforward. Having an absolute advantage just means you can crank out more of something than anyone else using the same amount of time and resources. That's it. It's all about raw output.
Okay, let's make this real with an example. Picture two economies. We'll just call them A and B. Now, if economy A puts all its energy into one thing for a year, it can make either 5 tons of oranges or 5 cannons. Got it? Okay. Now, economy B, in that same year, can produce 10 tons of oranges or, get this, 20 cannons.
So you look at those numbers and, I mean, it's a no-brainer, right? Economy B makes more oranges, and it makes way more cannons. So it has the absolute advantage in, well, both. It's just better at making everything.
And this is where it gets really interesting, because it begs the question, if you're economy B and you're better at everything, should you just do everything yourself? Your gut reaction might be, yeah, of course. But this is where economics throws a curveball, and it's a brilliant one.
Yeah, that brilliant answer is found in our second concept, comparative advantage. And this one, it's not about who's the best, it's all about the cost. Specifically, something called opportunity cost.
Opportunity cost is really the secret sauce here. Just think about it like this. Anytime you decide to do one thing, you are, by definition, deciding not to do something else. That something else you gave up, that's your opportunity cost. So having a comparative advantage just means your cost is lower. You sacrifice less.
So how in the world do we figure this out? It's actually a pretty simple little calculation. We're just going to look at the production ratio for each economy, simplify it down to find the cost for just one item, and then we compare them. Easy. Let's do it for our orange and cannon example.
All right, let's crunch the numbers, focusing on the cost of making oranges. For economy A, it's pretty simple. To make their 5 tons of oranges, they give up 5 cannons. So for every 1 ton of oranges, the cost is 1 cannon, a 1-for-1 trade-off. But now look at economy B. To make their 10 tons of oranges, they have to give up 20 cannons. You do the math. That means for every 1 ton of oranges, they give up 2 cannons. Wow, their cost is literally double that of economy A.
And boom, there it is. This is the big reveal. Even though economy B is the powerhouse, the one with the absolute advantage in everything, it's actually economy A that has the comparative advantage in making oranges. Why? Because their sacrifice, their opportunity cost, is way, way lower.
Okay, so who cares, right? Why is this little piece of economic theory so important? Well, because this one idea, it's the fundamental reason why specialization and trade work. It's why it makes sense for a country, or a company, or even a person to focus on the thing they have the lowest opportunity cost in, and then trade for everything else. It's how the whole pie gets bigger for everyone.
This is really the bottom line, so listen up. When you're trying to figure out who should specialize in what, absolute advantage, honestly, you can pretty much just throw it out the window. Like the quote says, it doesn't really have any meaning in this context. What really truly matters is who has the comparative advantage.
All right. To really see how this works in the real world, let's take it out of the realm of countries and cannons and bring it somewhere we can all relate to. Let's say you're managing a dental clinic and you've got 3 dentists on your team.
Okay, here are the stats for your team. In a single hour, dentist A can do 2 extractions or 12 fillings. Dentist B can do 2 extractions or 8 fillings.
And then you have Dentist C, who's a beast. They can do 4 extractions or 12 fillings in an hour. So right away, you can see Dentist C has the absolute advantage in extractions, right? They can do the most.
Okay, so you're the manager. Here's the puzzle. Your goal is to maximize what the whole clinic gets done in a day. So what's the play? Do you just put your best dentist, Dentist C, on everything? Or is there a more strategic way to think about this?
You know the drill by now, right? Let's figure out the opportunity cost. For Dentist C to do 1 extraction, they give up the chance to do 3 fillings. For Dentist B, 1 extraction costs them 4 fillings. And for Dentist A, man, 1 extraction costs a massive 6 fillings. So who has the lowest cost for extractions? It's Dentist C. They have the comparative advantage.
Okay, but now let's flip it. What about the cost of doing fillings? For Dentist A, doing 1 filling costs them only a tiny fraction, 1/6 of an extraction. For Dentist B, it's a quarter of an extraction. And for Dentist C, it's a third of an extraction. Whoa, look at that. The ranking is completely reversed. Dentist A has the lowest opportunity cost for fillings. They're the most efficient choice for that task.
And that, right there, is the secret to managing your clinic. You put Dentist C on extractions, where they have the comparative advantage. And you have Dentist A handle the fillings, where they have the comparative advantage. By specializing this way, based on opportunity cost, not just who seems best, the whole clinic, the whole team, becomes way more productive. It's not even close.
And look, this isn't just about economies or dental clinics. This way of thinking applies to everything. It applies to you, to your career path, to how you work with your team. The question isn't just, what am I best at? The much more powerful question is, what am I relatively best at? So I'll leave you with this to think about. What is your comparative advantage? What's the thing you can do where you give up the least? Because finding that, well, that's where you'll find your true superpower.